One of my cats was here yesterday. Now their hair's flying everywhere. Okay. That kind of changes my whole plan. God damn it. Well, hello my nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And I kind of rearranged my mic, so I hope the sound is good. And I have a naked face, very naked face. That is because today I am going to have fun with makeup again. And I am going to play with Nomad Cosmetics. I'm going to do palette bingo. So I have 4 palettes from Nomad Cosmetics. And the reason I have done nothing to my face at all, besides my skincare and sunscreen, is because I'm, as I said, going to do a palette bingo. If you don't know what a palette bingo is, it's basically 5 shades drawn randomly that you need to plop on your eyeball. But because I usually kind of need to think about what I want to do, I thought let's just, you know, do nothing, draw the shades and see from there. So yeah, let me grab pen and paper. One of my cats was here yesterday. Now their hair's flying everywhere. Wow. Pen and paper. Now I have 4 palettes and as I said, I kind of need to draw 5 shades. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw 2 shades from my favorite palette. So yeah. So let me get my random number generator. Oh. Yes. Where is it? There. Okay. Again, 4 palettes. So let's start by how I kind of have them here. So let's start with the first shade from the Encinitas. It has 4 shades. So here is the color story of this one. So let's do 1, 2, 4 and it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the way I'm going to draw them. So let's start with the first shade then, which is, let's see if we can get it in focus, is going to be number 1. That is the shade called Hang. So let's write that down. Okay, I will swatch everything later. Then the next quad is going to be the Malibu quad. 4, which is going to be Shack. Okay. Then we get Berlin. And Berlin has 15 shades. And the Berlin looks like this. And I'm going to count like that. Okay, 15 shades. So let's generate 7. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. It's called Helden. And then the last 2 are going to be from the Tokyo palette. And the Tokyo palette looks like this. My favorite. So let's draw. So we had number 7 from the previous palette. Really? Thank you. Number 10 and number 9. Okay. Very, very, very interesting color story. So let me swatch it out. Let's start with the Encinitas. I had the color Hang, which was this one. Yes. And then from the Malibu, I have the color Shack, which is that one. Then from the Berlin, I had the shade Helden, which is basically German and Dutch for heroes, which is a golden one. So that's kind of a nice color story in and of itself. So let me swatch it. Here. So yeah, that's not too bad. Then let's go to the Tokyo palette. Because the shades I got there are Gyaru, which is a pink shimmer. And the one next to it, which is a great, well, they're not really shimmers, they're satins. Which is a gray. So yeah, this is the color story. So I don't really know what to do about that. That I have a brown, I don't really mind that much. But I have 2 brown. Or should I put those on the lid? Oh, I could do that. I don't know. It's going to be, yeah. The shade Gyaru, this one by the way, is very, very pretty as a blush as well. If you like shimmery blushes. So what I'm going to do now is prime the face. Make sure that my eyes are ready to go. And then I will be back, hopefully with a plan. So wish me luck. I also need coffee, I think. Yes. I think I have a plan. But first, let me prime my eyes. So I have here the Kiko Milano Eye Base Because I kind of want that stickiness that it gives. Okay. I had a plan, didn't I? Yeah, I'm going to... Well, I have two mattes and I have two satins and the shimmer. I'm going to play with the shimmer. Basically, I'm going to play with everything. My plan is a neutral crease and then the light gray on the lid with the gold, but combined. And then that one in the inner part of my eye, I think. That was kind of the idea, so... Let's just go for it. I want to start with the Malibu palette and the color called Shack, which is the darkest color, this one. And it's going to go in the crease, outer corner, and all that. And I'm starting in the crease first. I'm concentrating the most color in the outer corner and then bringing it halfway in, because I don't really know what I want to do in the inner part of my eye. I just kind of want to place some color first, you know? And these shades are so easy to work with, they basically blend themselves. So yeah. Okay. Then I'm going to go to the Encinitas palette for the color Hang. Same brush. It's going to go on my inner eye part area. Yes, yeah. And I'm going to pull it a little bit over the darker shade and blend it out. Just to make sure I have a nice blend there. Okay, then I'm going to go back to the Malibu palette for the color Shack. I'm going to build it up a bit. And there's just a specific eye shape that I want. So that's why I'm looking that way, because I have a mirror there regularly to see if the shape is the way that I want it. Like so. Okay. I want it underneath my eye too, but for that I'm grabbing a small, different brush, because I kind of want to stamp it. Where is it? Here. I'm going to go to the color Shack. I'm just basically going to follow the line that I created down. Okay. Then I'm taking a different brush and I'm just going to make sure that it kind of, I don't know, makes sense. Or at least I hope so. I want my Morphe E36. I'm going to go to the color Shack and I want to create a line. I don't really mind it if it is messy on my lid, because I'm going to kind of cut the crease with my shimmer primer. But I kind of want, I don't know, something a little bit extra, like me. I want to basically frame the eye with darkness. Yes. I like this, actually, a lot. This and then just, I don't know, the color, what's the color? Cabana? The lightest shimmer just on your lid. Oh, very pretty. Let's kind of make sure I have a little bit of depth in the outer corner. Okay, next let's get my shimmer primer. So I have a flat brush and my glitter primer. I'm going to put some glitter primer on the brush and then I'm going to kind of carve out a shape. So, oh, that's a lot. That's, damn, it's too much, people. Okay, so now that I kind of have it a little bit over my lid, I'm going to swipe. I'm really looking down and stretching my eyelid to just make a nice line. I hope you can see that. I don't want to look forward, because then I kind of get creasing and I don't want that. It's basically the same effect as if you were to do a cut crease with a concealer. Only I am using my glitter primer. While looking down, I'm going to go into the color Kuroi Niji, I believe. It's the gray from the Tokyo palette. And it is a satin, but still, it does not matter. I'm going to put that in the inner eye part, whatever. There. Oh, these are so soft and creamy. Do I have pink in my brush? I don't, but I did not even realize that, but it looks like it has a... Really, Felicia? You did that? It looks like it has a pink shift. I did not know that. Really? There's no pink in my brush. I thought it was pink in my brush, but there's not. Wow. Okay. Hidden depth of the palette. Glad I discovered that. Yeah, I can see it in the swatch as well. When I look closely in the swatch, I can see that it has a pink shift. I did not know that, people. That kind of changes my whole plan. Goddammit. Now, I have worked with this shade before and it really comes out on top of that glitter primer. Yeah, I'm still going to do what I had in mind. So now I'm going to go to the Berlin palette for the color called Helden, which was this one. Same brush, because why not? And I'm going to put it here, lightly. Now, wow, you know, I loved the color, that gray color that I used, but now I love it even more. I'm going to go one side the color Helden, the gold, the other side the color the gray. And I'm going to mix, just make sure that they blend nicely. Now, I kind of know that they put a little bit of hidden depth in their palettes, but I'm just really blown away, actually. Wow. Wow. Okay. Yeah, I want a little bit more of the gray, just a little bit further. Now, what's the idea was then to kind of put the pink in the inner corner. But I'm first going to put the pink here, I think. So let me get a brush for that. And then I'm going to go into the color called Giaru, this one. How's that? Is that fun?
I don't know.
I also kind of want to bring it a little bit back here. I'm just tapping it over. Just to get that pink a little bit more, I don't know, popping. I don't know. Yeah, I'm well aware that I kind of hit the gold because, yeah, I think I'm going to change my plan. So, flat brush in the color Giaru, the pink. I'm going to spray it now with some water. I'm going to put it here on top of the gold. I will use the gold on another in my inner corner in a minute. And then pink one side, gray on the other. Just going to make sure that it flows nicely. Yeah, okay, I want a little bit more of the gray. But I'm going to spray because I kind of need that stickiness then. Then I'm going to go back to the, what you call again, the Malibu palette for the color Shack. Let's grab my Morphe E36 for that. Do I have a light pink eye pencil? Ew. I don't know, but I do have this one. So let's grab this one, which is from Essence in the color Life in Pink. Okay, then I'm grabbing the color Giaru, the pinky one. I'm going to spray. I'm just going to intensify it here a bit. Okay, then I'm going to go to the color Helden from the Berlin palette. And it's going to go in the inner corner because that's the only place I have left. Yeah, I think that's it. I actually quite like this, I think. I don't want to pull it up a little. I like this. What I'm going to do now is liner and mascara. Yes. And coffee. Liner, mascara and coffee. Oh, it's nice to look up your nostrils. So here are the eyes just before the falsies that I'm going to put on now. They are going to be my natural ones. My natural ones in style London. If you want to know how I put on my falsies, I have a tutorial linked down in the description box. I'm also going to put on the rest of my face. Yes, and then I will be back to show you the final result, I think. Yeah. Hold on tight, don't go anywhere. I'll be back in about 3.5 hours. And here is the finished look. I really like how it turned out, and I'm still kind of blown away by that gray from the Tokyo palette, that it has that pink iridescent shift. Oh, I really, really love it. For lips, I'm just going to mention the lippy I have on. It's the Catrice Matte Pro Ink Non-Transfer Liquid Lipstick in the color 050 My Life, My Decision. And I think it complements the look very, very nicely. So yeah, this is it. This is what I created with these four palettes and the wonky color story. So yeah, let me know down below if you have any of the palettes. I know some of you do. I know some of you got the Tokyo palette when it was on their spring sale. Yeah, that's not very good grammar, but you know what I mean anyway. So yeah, have you played with her yet? How do you like her? Let me know down in the comment section. The rest of my makeup will be down in the description box if you are curious to see what else I have on my face. This was my fun with makeup video, palette bingo with all the palettes that I have from Nomad Cosmetics. Let me know down below if you enjoyed this video. If you are new to my channel, thank you so, so much for coming over and clicking on this video. I would love it if you would consider subscribing and becoming part of my nest. Never mind. it sounds sinister, but yeah, that's neither here nor there. Sometimes I'm sinister as well. Or I just forget I said anything. Let's just go about our day. I'm going to thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay sensible as well. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.